Hello friends, welcome back to my channel Learn HTML with Nandu Jadhav, and today we are going to discuss lists in HTML. So let us start. So lists are used to group the related information together, and by using this grouped information we can present our document with well structured. We can create our document with more accessible, and that well structured and more accessible documents created by using lists can easily read and maintain. So the lists are very important. HTML also include the list in HTML 3.0 and later version. So in HTML there are three kinds of list. The first one, that is the order list. Second one, that is the unordered list, and third one, that is the definition list, or we can also say description list. So one by one sequentially we'll start the three kinds of the list provided by HTML. The first one is ordered list, also we can call as a numbered list. This numbered list is used to display the such kind of list items that must be placed in a specific order. At that time we need to use the first, that is the ordered list. This ordered list, if you change the order of list items, then the meaning of the such kind of documents will be changed. So it is necessary to display the list items in a specific order, and to create the specific order list we can use this ordered list or numbered list. To create an ordered list or numbered list, HTML provides us the OL tag. This OL stands for ordered list and is a pair tag, and its closing is compulsory. If we check the attributes of this OL tag, then there are three main attributes of the OL tag. The first attribute, that is the type. The type attribute tells the browser the list marker, that means the list created by using order list is displayed in which factor, in which marker, by using one, by using uppercase alphabets, by using lowercase alphabets, that is. So the type attribute provides the type of numbering, that is the type of list marker, and it consists five values. The first one he see here, that is the, this one is the one. Second one is uppercase A. Third one is lowercase a. Next one is uppercase Roman numbers, and next one, that is the lowercase Roman numerals. So these are the five values of this type. If we check the first one, that is the OL type equal to 1, then the created list will be displayed like this one. In this example, we create a COVID-19 top cases countries list. This one is the, and is displayed the five countries, America to Peru, and these lists are displayed with a list marker 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That is, these are the Arabic numbers. If you see the source of this one, you see here the OL tag is used without using any type attribute here. Just only we write OL, and within the OL the five list items are placed here, the li, by using the li tag. We'll discuss li tag later, but this li tag is used to insert list item in the list, in the order list. Here we can say in the order list. Okay, and after the closing of this, all finishing of this all list item, the OL tag is closed. Here, without using type attribute, our output will be displayed with 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, that is using Arabic numerals or using these list markers, because the default type of OL is Arabic numerals, that is first one, that is the 1. If you set the value of type as a uppercase alphabet A, then output will be displayed like this one. That is the uppercase A, B, C, D, E, F. Okay, here instead of 1, 2, 3, 4, the list marker will be displayed with uppercase alphabets. And to display this, we need to use the OL's attribute, that is the type equal to uppercase A, that is the uppercase alphabets. And this uppercase alphabet displays the list with the list marker A, B, C, D, E. Okay, like this one and uppercase alphabets, we can also use the lowercase alphabets here. This is the lowercase alphabet list. We can also create uppercase Roman number list also. See here, the Roman uppercase list 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So we can use here these four type to set the value of type attribute. So especially here we can say the type attribute provides the type of numbering, or it tells the browser which type of marker will be used to create a ordered list. Okay, then our next attribute is reversed attribute. This reversed attribute display the list markers only in a reverse order. Okay, see here, with example we will discuss. Here is the example of this these five countries. And the list markers are used Arabic numerals. Here the first list one is America, last one is Peru, but the list markers is changed in a descending order. Okay, we can see here the 5 4 3 2 1, that means the lists by default they are displayed in ascending order 1 2 3 4 5, but here by using reversed attribute the list markers only display in descending order. And here we will see OL type equal to Arabic numerals. No need to use this type, but just I used here. And its important attribute here is, that is the reversed. This reversed attribute reverse the list markers only. Okay, list markers in a descending order. This one is the second attribute. Then the third attribute of OL tag is start. It defines the start value of the order list. You know that the default start value for order list is 1. That means the list created with the list marker Arabic numerals, that is the 1, 2, 3, 4, or list marker with alphabets, uppercase alphabets are started with A, B, C, D. That means the starting value of any order list is by default 1. And suppose you want to change to 1 to any number, then this start attribute is used. See, with the example here, the list of that five countries is displayed here from America to Peru. But here this list is displayed with list marker starting from I, not from A. Okay, that is the displayed list is started from I, because here the value for this start attribute is defined as a 9. Okay, so I is the 9 number character in the alphabet. So the list is displayed here from the character or list marker I. And later the all next list items will continue from the I to J, K, L, M, like that. Okay, so this one is the start attribute of the order list. Next, the second list, that is the unordered list. We can also say the bulleted list also. And this bulleted list, in this bulleted list, or this kind of list is used where there is no any specific orders for the list items. At that time you can use this unordered list. And this unordered list is created by using UL tag. This UL tag is also a pair tag and its closing is compulsory like OL tag. This UL tag consists a single attribute, and that single attribute is a type. This type, like OL's type, indicates the list marker. But here list marker is in form of disk, circle and square. That means the list markers are displayed here in a bullet forms, and that bullet forms provided in HTMLs are disk, circle or square. Okay, if you see the example of this UL type, we'll see here all displayed here, or three bullet types are displayed. The first list is with disk second list is with circle and third list is with square list marker. Okay, here three different kinds of the different types of the unordered list is displayed here. If we see the its code, then we will see here the first list, that is the UL. There is no need to use type equal to disk, because the disk is the default type for the unordered list. So the type attribute is not used with the first UL tag, but rather the other two UL tag, UL type equal to circle, that the second list will display all the list items with circle as a list marker, and here in third one square as a list marker. Okay, one thing I noted while practically performing in different web browser, in Microsoft Edge, if we set the value of type attribute this circle, C-I-R-C-L-E, that the total spelling circle, in uppercase or in a title case, like square in uppercase or title case, then the list will display with the default bulleted list, that is the disk. That means I think and I practically verify that the Microsoft Edge web browser display the contents in a proper circle or in a proper square list marker when we give the value in a lowercase. Okay. Then we will see the important one, that is the li tag. Li stands for list item tag. This li tag is used to insert list items within the order list, unordered list, and in a menu list. The third one, we know the order list and unordered list, but the third one, that is the menu list, in HTML5 provide menu tag to create a menu list, and in this list, as like ordered and unordered list, the list items are included by using this li tag. If you see the attribute of li tag, there is a single attribute, that is a value. This value attribute is used when li tag is used only within the ol tag, remember. So this one is the value attribute which specifies the start value of the list item. We will see with the example here. Here the displayed list is COVID-19 countries list with the lowercase alphabets A, B. See here, the A for America, B Brazil, G India, H Russia, and I Peru. That means the list is break here from or after B and start with G. That means when you want to change the list marker value in between the list, at that time we can use this attribute, that is the value. See here, the OL type equal to lowercase alphabets. Okay, so the first and second, that is the America and Brazil, first two list items will be displayed with A and B. But for the third, that is for the India, the li used value attribute, and the value is assigned as a 7. So this 7 display the G. That means the G is the 7 number alphabets. So the list is displayed with G. But after that, then if the new list items are there, then it continue the G, H, I, like these options. Okay. So this one is the value attribute of li tag. The third list type is definition list. In HTML5, this definition list is renamed as a description list. Okay, by using this definition list, we can also call it as a glossary list. This glossary list or definition list or current, that is the description list, is used to create a terminology pages. Or suppose you want to create or define multiple definitions in a web, single web page, at that time such kind of list is very useful. This definition list or description list is created by using DL tag. This DL tag is a paired tag and its closing is compulsory. This DL tag holds DT tag as well as DD tag. We will check here first the syntax of this DL tag. See here, the first one, that is the DL tag, which indicates the starting of the description list, and this closing tag indicates the description list is closed here. Within this DL tag, there is a DT tag is placed, and that DT stands for definition term. That means the DT tag defines the term word. Okay, and within the DT, there is another tag, that is DD, which stands for definition description. Here, the description about the definition term is given. So this is the syntax of the DL tag. Okay, we will see this with the example. See here, the one glossary list or description list is created, which contains nearly five terms, term words with their description. And if we see the source of this, see here, the DL tag is used here, which starts our definition list. And within the DL, the first DT, that the first term word is defined, that is the hypertext. This hypertext is a term word defined within the DT. And after DT, there is a DD tag is used. This DD tag give description about this term word. So the hypertext is the term word, and in the first DD, see here two DD tags are used. See here, in the first DD, the actual definition of hypertext is given. Suppose you want to give additional description, extra information, we can use multiple DD like this, with multiple DD tags, and this multiple DD tags gives multiple description within the single DD, remember. Okay, the closing of DD is not a compulsory, first thing, and here also the closing of DT is also not compulsory, because when you start the another DT, the automatically first DT will be closed, considered by the web browser. But as per our syllabus, remember, the DT tag, DD tag and DL tag all are paired, and their closing are compulsory. So this one is the definition list or glossary list or description list. Okay, so another one, that is the nested list. So nested list means a list within another. That means we can place single list within the another list. We can list again insert another list within that. That means we can insert multiple list within each other, and that multiple list within each other can said as a nested list. We will see with the example here. See, the example here is given. Here the main list is used in form of countries, that the India and Australia specially created or defined with the bulleted list. Within the bulleted list, there is another list are available. The first list is, that is the ABC, that means uppercase alphabets list, that is the order list, which contains three values: Maharashtra, Karnataka and Rajasthan. In Maharashtra, there are another two options, but in Maharashtra, that two options are the sub options. So that are placed within the Maharashtra, and that within the Maharashtra means this order list with lowercase alphabets are nested within the uppercase alphabet list, and this uppercase alphabet order list is nested within the unordered list. So this one is the best example, we can say this one is the nested list. So this is the list provided by HTML. I hope you understood all the kinds of list very well. If you have any doubt, you can give suggestion me in comment. And in our next videos, we will discuss the forms in HTML, how forms are designed, how tables are used and created, how images are inserted, and how hyperlinks are created. one by one sequentially we will go through this video series. So to learn all these things, keep watching, keep learning, and stay with me. Thank you.